We here at the Gaming Zone Riff Tracks always support any and all that involve the creation and distribution of any show we feature, and we encourage any of those watching to support the official release. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen! Coming to you pre-recorded from our internet couch, this is the Gaming Zone Riff Tracks for August 20th, 2016. We're your host, BeastBreaker2448.
And ramp it up, Slon.
We are back with our last look at Double before we take a quick break to watch Pokemon X and Y in the first two episodes. And we have an interesting little two episodes to stop on. We are taking a look at episodes 15 and 16, The F Afterglow, Burglary Rider, and Recover Your Partner. These are essentially the Fang Joker debut episodes. And a bit of trivia, Fang made its first debut in Movie Tyson 2010 in a flashback scene in the movie. I think we'll touch upon that in these two episodes. I don't think we would see the footage that's in the movie.
I don't remember it right offhand.
I don't think we do.
Hmm.
But yeah, we got a good little two-parter here, but any thoughts going into this two-parter?
No, not really. I know that... I know that we're in for good episodes on this one.
Mm-hmm. Hell, this is the first two episodes of Double where we get a proper form debut episode.
Which, that's kind of funny.
Yeah. What is this? 15 episodes in and we are now doing a form debut episode. Like, that is insane to say, considering, like, the recent writer shows. Like, no. I'm trying to think, like, time to a form debut for, like, the last couple series. Ghost was immediately the next, and within the next episode, because that was Edison. Drive, I think, was under 5 to Wild.
I even think it was only a few past that to Technique.
Mm-hmm. Guy was... was the next episode because it was Pine. Or when... No, it was episode 3 to debut Pine, I think. Crap, I'm trying... I might be wrong on that. But forms come out fairly quick.
Yeah.
I think O's might have something comparable because it might have been a little bit longer to get to me. I think Gatakiriba was the next major, was the next form debut for O's. But yeah, forms get thrown out real quick these days. So it's nice to see we take longer and we actually build up Fang Joker here, as we'll be seeing. But links to the subs are down below with TV Hound subs as always. So if you want hard copies, go get TV Hound hard copies. But we'll be starting the episode here in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, and good news, I should have all my books covered. The only problem might be my circuits book. Apparently, it's on back order through the damn bookstore. That I have to buy through because no one is going to be able to get the book to me quick enough. Which, I blame the bookstore for not, you know, telling me fast enough, because I was able to contact both of the teachers for the class and get answers within a couple hours about what book I needed. Also, fuck the circuits class for switching to the second edition of the damn book for no reason the next semester. Yes. To be fair, Philip, this is normal. Water bottle! Sure it is. See, water bottle, how hard is that? It's a nice way of putting it. Well, they're right here. Thank you, Shutter, for that clarification.
Yes, because a masked person on a bike has to be a Kamen Rider. Can't be a monster.
I think you're taking the name Kamen Rider a little too literally.
Yep.
Plus, I like that, weirdly enough, an episode that kind of ties in to the first film for Double is the first episode to bring up the Kamen Rider title, or I wouldn't say bring up the Kamen Rider title, but bring up the thing that the show does with that title that I don't think they really do anything more until A to Z, I don't think. Because just as a heads up, Shotaro takes that title real personally and does not like it when people just use that title. Now, I should marathon at the very least the double portions of the movies in A to Z at some point. Especially since we're not going to be watching any of those movies.
Yeah, because we've kind of done them all.
Well, we've done two of them. We can't do, or we could do double O's since it's so far, like, does not represent O's. It doesn't matter if you've watched O's or not. Like, I think we could watch two episodes of O's and go straight into double O's and not miss a beat. Especially since that O's portions is such garbage. Granted, the superior crossover film Double got to be a part of is Bangamax, and we damn sure can't watch that until we watch the entirety of O's. Are there not people who have seen Double in Action are like, no, no, he's more multicolored than this guy. Also, he doesn't have a big-ass gun for a hand. Drive all the way out to the pier just to send Bat off? That seems a bit presumptuous. You know, I have to wonder how hard it is to do new memories. They never really explain the process of how the memories are made. At least I don't remember them ever doing it. Granted, I don't think Tokusatsu ever gets real technobabbly. to use a Star Trek term. It's like, this stuff just works. We don't try to explain it. Because if we try to explain it, then people are going to have to ask questions eventually. Or point out how that doesn't work that way. Well, that's just a dick thing to do. Just like, at least take something. Oh god, those smoke effects, they look horribly placed. Or horribly 2D. The old, just speed up the footage. That implies you're going faster. It's something to go off of. You know, I will say, out of any effect, I think Toei's mastered the split-screen effect, considering how often they use it.
True.
Look at Akiko being good at detective work. You do realize you're on a line, right? You can't really fall that poorly. That seems super small time for an organized group of thieves. Like, if you're a group of thieves, I would expect you to steal from more important places than convenience stores. Look at Shotaro trying to be all hard-boiled and shit. I'm gonna say yes. Granted, we only ever see the one time Shotaro and Skull interact. Or Narumi interact, so... As well, let's see what comes up. Damn it. I think for the end of the show, I'm going to go back through all these moments and go and examine them, see what's actually written on that shit. See if I can dig up some interesting facts or something. Look at Philip being the ones like, we need a plan! And why would he do that? You know, I think this guy was in Kiva. As some as a spider fan guy, I believe. At least I think that's him.
That wouldn't surprise me in all honesty.
Also, doesn't this look like the guy from the first couple episodes of Drive? Or is that just me?
I don't know. By the way, as many times as they've done that in front of someone, you would think the entire city would know by now.
Very true. I mean, it's not like Chotaro Philip really, or like Chotaro really hides Double's identity.
Yeah, it's not like how Tamari was for the beginning of Drive. It's like they really don't care who knows. But at the same time, they don't go out of their way to make it well known.
Yeah. And honestly, the only people who really know are the people they beat and, like, their clients. I'm sure the clients keep the secret because, we owe you, I guess. That's how that goes. That little 3D model right there. That looked a little bad. Where the hell were you keeping that walkie-talkie at?
You probably don't want to know.
Just pull that out of Hammer Space. Which, funny enough, someone on Tumblr brought up the question of, like, where the hell does Yuzu keep her fan at? And it's just one of those, she keeps it in Hammer Space. Or in this case, Fan Space. Well, someone figured out how the belt works. You know, you think they give the goons something better than the little pistols. Like, at least give them some fancy guns. Or, like, a smaller version of the trigger pistol. Oh shit, I didn't think they revealed this early.
I didn't either. I thought it was lighter.
Yeah, I thought that was like a mid-show reveal.
Dang.
Because, like, Shroud's not even here yet.
Yeah. I thought it was closer to then. Dang. Well then, that shows you it's been a while since either one of us have watched this.
Yeah. I'm like, oh yeah, they reveal it because Shroud's around. When Shroud's around, but I'm like, no, Shroud's not even in the show yet.
Yeah, because she don't come into play until after...
She goes into play when Terry starts to show up.
Yeah.
Because she's the one that's responsible for the Axel gear. Granted, I think she's the one responsible for all of the gear in the show.
More than likely, yeah.
I mean, at the very least, like, the double drive, I think, like, the lost driver up, she's responsible for. I mean, hell, Movie War Core confirms that, like, Shroud was working with Narumi when he was Skull. Because she's the one responsible for the Skull Gary. That then got repurposed into the Revolve Gary, which how the fuck we went from Skull Gary to Revolve Gary is a question of itself. Considering I don't think it had any attachments. Although the Figure Arts bike I think can still detach. Because they're both the same bike. Yeah, Skull's bike is essentially Double's bike, but the Double crest on it is spray painted black, and it's black and red. Or it's mainly black with a little bit of red, just like the Skull Magnum is.
Huh.
But it was never shown to, like, do different attachments, and I don't think Skull Gary had any attachments to it to begin with, so... I don't know. Anyway, y'all said in the second episode?
Yep.
Alright, take a look at the seventh episode here in 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, aside to look into 3DS emulators, apparently there is a working 3DS emulator at this point, maybe.
Really?
Maybe. The only reason I was looking into 3DS emulators was like, play a ROM of Traveler Senkai was what I was wanting to do. But that would then entail getting a hold of a ROM of that game.
Yeah.
Well, this is going well. They show something completely different. That isn't quite like what happened, or at least what initially happened.
Well, that was uncalled for.
Yeah. It is not nice to punch people in the gut. It's even ruder to punch them in the dick. Mm-hmm. Which I swear half the time that's what it's supposed to be. Mm-hmm. Which, taking a punch to the gut and knocking you immediately out is the Japanese trope for some reason. Well, that's one way to save on the budget. Now that I think about it, because I was thinking about... Because I had a thought about what Forze did once. And Dumble, I don't think, ever did, in that they never showed someone using a dopant memory for good.
Yeah, true.
Because Forze had one of the horoscopes be a good guy.
Huh.
Unfortunately, with how Forze did the horoscopes late into the show, they had to just burn them out every couple of episodes. So we weren't quite treated to this good guy horoscope for long. But that was something they did. Of course, I don't think O's ever did a good guy greed, but considering how the greeds reform, that would might be impossible. But I think it might be possible with the dopants.
I would think it would. At the least, they could have done something like Drive did with the Roid Mutes and have the one that was not really bad or good kind of deal, just the neutral kind of concept.
Yeah. Of course, it's been interesting to see someone become a dopant for just really random reasons.
Yeah.
Don't they have two stack phones?
I thought they did. But I don't guess so.
Yeah, because it's like, why not use Philip's stack phone? It's also very rude to shove your leg into someone's grazed bullet wound? Hi again. Okay, guys, is everyone going to show up right now?
Yep.
Wait, are they gonna throw in the fucking movie order shit? Nah, you have like 30 plus episodes left, plus you'll be around for like 2 more series.
Yeah.
But at least Shotaro will. Well, Shotaro Philip will. An idea they never play with again until the double novel. Where we get a wolf memory. Think is a DuPont memory. I'll need to dig into a YouTube video I follow to see if I can dig up the collection or video of that Guy Murray collection. Who the hell did you see?
Huh.
I also do love how this two-parter did not start out. It did not start trying to draw parallels between these pair of partners, but now it did. But technically, he stole it from like everyone in fucking movies when they're about to die, but that's beside the point. Not his hat!
Anything but the hat.
He probably only has so many black hats. One of the few times Philip ever rides the bike. You know, you should probably not pull from his playbook. Also, I love how fucking this little fucking raptor is able to hold up Shotaro without fucking issue. And throw him.
Well, I mean, he's not an ordinary guy of memory, so...
A double you don't want to fuck with.
At all.
Yeah. Well, you did hear about part of this, you just didn't hear about all of it. Also, I feel bad for the Goon Squad.
Especially this Goon Squad.
Yeah. Of course, love how it takes us a fucking movie to introduce the goons of Double. You might want to get a stronger caliber. I don't think he's gonna stop. Plus, you're talking to the wrong person. You're probably to be talking to the belt. Good thing that only took like 1 second.
Yeah, seriously.
Mm-hmm. I do love how Philip has his own pose for the catchphrase.
Yeah, it is a nice touch.
Mm-hmm. And I also love the little piece of trivia we get with this episode as well. For those wondering, that line references the fact that gives away the fact that all of the finishers, Shotaro named them. I just love that little gesture. Like, oh yeah, Shotaro's the one who names all the damn finishers. Because of course he would.
Yeah.
I guess we're just gonna take care of that gunk on the driver in between cuts. Consider we forgot to take care of that before we de-transform, but oh well.
Well, maybe the transformation into Fang Joker broke it loose.
Nope, it was there, but there before they cut. It was there when he cut the rope.
Oh. Well. Whoops.
It literally disappeared between cuts.
Whoops.
And Nazca with the save. You're lucky to have him. Right.
Punch him.
God, I just love the little touch of the suit acting of the fact that it's two different people in the suit and how they play with that. Just the little moments when they do something with that. Just go with that and don't worry about it. That's awful nice of her. Even though she technically didn't have to do that, but whatever.
Yeah.
And with that note, it's official that Double's only been operating for like a year now. Yeah, the stack phone or the beat phone. There's the other nod to the thing from Movie War 2010, because Terry also made his first appearance in 2010 at the end. Although they didn't show the beat phone, so even if you went and saw the movie, you might not know what that phone means. Because the only thing they showed in the movie was the driver and the memory. The memory. They didn't show the driver. Yeah. Anyway, how are we feeling after these two episodes?
I honestly didn't feel like it, like this arc had originally happened at this point. Like, I felt like it was a little bit lighter in the show.
Well, with all the Raito stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm with you. I was just like, oh yeah, that's something that happens later.
Nope. Of course, I don't think that it matters how many times you watch that arc. That kind of is one of the big points in the show.
Yeah. Especially since they just drop it right there. It's like, oh yeah, his real name's Raito. It's like, wait, what?
Yeah, but they still don't go to the rest of the points with it.
Yeah.
Which, that might be where we're getting it confused.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm wanting to say we know more later, but yeah.
It's weird going back and watching Double and realizing things happen sooner than you thought they did. I think that happens for me because I think Double has blended together a whole lot since I watched it. So I'm like, oh yeah, like Fang showed up and then Axel shows up. And I'm like, let's see, how long does it take for you to show up? Or Terry to show up? Wait, it's episode 19? Wait a minute!
Oh wow.
Wait a minute, that next start is when that happens?
When what happened?
Nazca.
Oh.
Yeah, that's the next arc.
Huh.
And then Terry shows up. And the following arc.
Huh.
I didn't think that all went back to back to back.
Well then.
We just roll it into important shit. Jesus!
Okay.
I was totally expecting to look in the episode list and be like, oh yeah, it's a filler arc next week. No! No, it's not!
Huh?
No, it's the important part of Nazca's entire arc for this beginning part of the show. And then the following week, Terry debuts. With Axel, and I'm like, when does Double have its filler? Is it after Axel is when we get a filler arc? Because we just rolling in the shit for the next couple weeks. Let me see. Da-da-da-da. Okay. So we have filler work. Then we start that. Okay. We start the weather stuff then. All right. Well, we're still going to be on track for that. We're still doing our plan. So next week, we'll be hopping into the Kalos region for the first two episodes of Pokemon X and Y. And then the following week, we'll be the important part of Nazca's arc for the entire beginning part of the show. So, yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Wow.
I love how Double is managing to surprise us, even though we have watched the show before.
Well, it's because the key points we're thinking were spaced out more because of the fact of how... let's see here. How Wizard did us. How
Drive
did us.
How Ghost was really terrible at it.
But tried to do it.
Yeah.
I mean... Dang.
We're at episode 17! We're, like, these are six very important episodes that are all happening back-to-back-to-back in under the 20-episode mark. This does not happen!
Literally going up to the 20 mark.
Yeah.
Ugh.
And then it's a filler arc, and then weather shows up! Which is important!
Like, really, that filler arc... That's, what, the midpoint in the show?
Yeah.
So... Yeah. Well, not quite the midpoint.
Yeah,
there was 48 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Like, the first half of the show, so much crap has already happened.
Mm-hmm. And people wonder why Wizard is still loved to this day. This is why! This is why Gaia Memories were able to sell what we're still selling.
Yeah. Wizard.
Yeah. Well, yeah, Double's still good. And why Gaia Memories were still being sold well into Wizard's run of the show. And Wizard's run. And also, why Double's novel is the only one that has something exclusive in it to get a figure out of. And memories out of, too. Like, the rest of the writer novels, nothing's really came out of those. But Double got a figure art in the form of Kamen Rider Cyclone, got the memories from that novel brought made physical toys and sold. Like, nothing from the O's novel, which I don't think there's anything from the O's novel to be sold to begin with. I think all the O's novel... there's nothing from the O's novel. The Forze novel has its own goddamn writer, and so does the Wizard novel. Hell, Kuga has its own writer. Has a brand new writer show up in the novel. The Kuga novel! With two forms! And nothing! But Double somehow gets material. Double still gets products because it sold stupidly well. Granted, O's so better, and so did Gaim, but Gaim has shown itself to follow Double's model and had two Gaim Gaiden films with the possibility of a third. And the only reason the third didn't happen is because I guess enough people weren't interested in it at the time.
Or well, look at how far into Drive's run we were by the time that would have even been a thing.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I have a funny feeling the time frame might have helped slack that up.
Yeah. And hell, Drive is shown to be successful enough to get two. They also get two guidance, in this case, two extended Drive films. because we got the Chase V-Cinema, and this fall we're getting the Heart Mock V-Cinema that will debut during X8's run. Of course, the question of the quality of it is still up in the air.
Lord knows Ghost won't have one.
Oh no, if Ghost gets any extended material, I will be shocked.
Okay. I honestly think if Ghost gets extended material at this point, it's going to be to try to fix the problems the show had. It ain't going to be to try to be like post-show.
Mm-hmm. And to be honest, outside of Spectre and Necrom, there's no one to do extended material for.
Yeah, they kind of make sure of that.
Uh-huh. Like, there's no one to do extended material for. So, like, Drive, like, had to bank on both of its secondary writers for extended material and then rope Heart in, but Heart got to be a standout character for the entire show, and they're giving him a writer form for reasons and reviving him for reasons, but they're not reviving Chase because I don't know why.
I don't know. I don't understand that either. Like, why are we refusing to bring Chase back? Because that's what it is at this point. Because, look, Genesis, there was ways they could have wrote that one in and made it work. But they refused to. These Drive Saga movies, they could technically do whatever they needed to rewrite him in it.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not. It's like, why are we refusing?
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
I could say it's like, spoilers for O's, I could say it's like Ankh, where Ankh is a major character of O's that can easily be revived, but Megamax confirms that Ankh is revived at some point. So, even I have to go, Chase can be easily revived, theoretically, but they're not doing it, but because of the recent trailer, because the trailer did come out for Mock Heart, the Mock Heart film, and it's confirmed because of the last couple seconds of that trailer that Chase is in the movie. But because of the context of that scene, I think it's just he's manifesting through the Mock Chaser signal bike shift car. Because he's holding it in the scene. So he's just like tossing it to go. And he's just manifesting it, or he's just a hallucination because Mock got the shit kicked out of him. Because that's when Chase shows up, is when Go get the shit kicked out of him, and then he goes Mock Chaser, which, by the way, it is Mock Chaser, and the signal bike shift car announces it as Mock Chaser and then just plays their tunes back to back. That's it. So, nothing real fancy.
Huh. But, I mean, we've discussed that before.
Yeah.
According to the end of Drive, Go has Chase's signal bike.
Mm-hmm.
We know the viral cores are now a part of that signal bike.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that his signal bike was actually, if you remember correctly, it was actually made from a piece of him.
Yeah.
So, why can't we revive him?
Why isn't there a theoretical backup of Chase in there? Like, all of it, like, this writes itself.
It's like it's all laid out in front with big letters saying revive.
Yeah.
Yet, this isn't like, it's like, nope, we're not doing it, nope.
This isn't like with reviving Kaito from Gain. Like, reviving Kaito,
that would take some major trying to figure out a way to do that.
Yeah.
That especially, I don't think you'd ever get right.
Yeah. Especially, even though there is that small little 2-second, depending on your interpretation, tease of Kaito being back, if you remember that, those 2 seconds from the end of the film. Like, one could potentially interpret that as like, oh, maybe he survived that, but because of how that is, like, that can't be the case. I think that's just a... We're teasing you with the idea, but if you think about it, we're not. Plus, like, Kaito would refuse revival anyway. Like, his entire character? I would believe him to be like, no, fuck you, I'm gonna stay dead.
I died, I'm dead. You're not bringing me back, screw you. Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah. Of course, I think, like, a weird interpretation of Gaimgaiden 2, which, did you ever watch Gaimgaiden 2?
Nope.
Oh. A weird interpretation of Gaimgaiden 2 is that Knuckle dies at the end of that film. Which, that's one interpretation of it, but I have a different interpretation of he lives, because the reason people think he dies is because the film ends with him and Kaito doing a dance together. As Kaito, and eventually Kaito disappears during the dance, leaving Knuckle alone, or Zack alone, dancing. But I take that as because the entirety of Zack's Gaiden story revolves around his relationship with Kaito and someone misinterpreting Kaito's, his relationship with Kaito and someone else's relationship with Kaito, because it's very much about Team Baron, more so than it is about Zack. I take that ending to mean Zack lives because Kaito is dead, therefore he disappears. Like, Zack is alone because he surpassed Kaito now as the leader of Team Baron.
That was kind of like the passing of the torch kind of deal.
Mm-hmm. Like, he lives. And I think because of... Ah, shit. What was it? Oh, fuck. I forgot what it was. But, oh yeah, the Gaim novel that came out. I believe the Gaim novel takes place after the Gaidens, and it confirms Zack's alive. Because he's in the novel, and like... and it continues the story from that Gaiden. And I believe it's just them three, Takatora and Ryugen. And they are the five riders that are protecting Zawami City.
Huh.
Because they go on to take down, like, some terrorist organization that is a part of Gaiden 2.
Hmm.
Yeah. Anyway, until next week, that'll do it for
Ramp It Up Slong.
Excuse me. I'm Pacemaker 2448, continuing to have a cough because it refuses to go away. Saying goodnight, everybody. We'll see you on the next round of the Game of Sleep Drift Tracks. Peace out.
Don't forget to check out the links in the top and the bottom and the other shows in the annotations. Also, for those on mobile, all the links are in the description below. Till next time.